Let's go over the answer to the assessment you just took. The question was, which graph represents the derivative of f of x? So let's take a closer look at f of x. Here it is. So it's an upward-facing parabola, and it has a minimum at x equals 2. So let's use what we know about the relationship between a graph and the graph of its derivative to try and write down a few facts for what we would expect the derivative to look like. And then we can try to match up those facts with our choices. Okay, so what's the first thing I notice about this function f of x? Well, first of all, it starts out decreasing. Okay, so I'm decreasing over here, and I continue to decrease until I reach this local minimum. So what does it tell me about the derivative if I have a function that's decreasing? Well, when the function is decreasing, I know that the derivative is negative. So let me out to the side here, write down some properties for what we expect of the derivative, f prime of x. Well, we expect it to be negative from negative infinity to 2, because that's where the original function is decreasing. Okay, so then what happens at 2? At 2, we reach a local minimum right here. Now, whenever we're at a local minimum or maximum, we have a horizontal tangent line, and that tells me my derivative is going to be 0 at that point. So then I expect my derivative to be 0 when x equals 2. Okay, so f of x should be 0 when x equals 2. Okay, and then what happens? My graph starts to increase, and it continues to increase for the rest of the time. So whenever the original function is increasing, that means my derivative is positive on that interval. So then I know that the derivative should be positive from 2 to infinity. Okay, so let's see if any of our graphs match those characteristics. Okay, so what about choice A? Well, choice A is just a horizontal line. It's constant at the line y equals 2. So that doesn't meet any of my criteria. So I know that my answer is not choice A. What about choice B? Okay. Well, choice B is a line, and it starts out negative. Okay, so that's good. I see that my line is negative until we get to 2, and then I see that I cross the axis. So my function is 0 when x equals 2, and then my function is positive for the rest of time. So it's positive from 2 to infinity. So that meets all my criteria. So choice B is the correct answer. In this case, we can briefly look at choice C. The thing that's wrong with choice C is that it actually starts out positive and then goes negative, but that's opposite of what we want. We want something that starts out negative and goes positive, like we saw in choice B. So that's how you match up a graph to its derivative.